Well, Professor James Goff is from the National Hazards Research Laboratory at the University of New South Wales and an expert in cyclones. He joins us now. Thank you very much for your time tonight, James. Now, what can people, residents, expect over the next few hours, the ones that are going to bear the brunt of Cyclone Yasi?
Well, the ones that are going to bear the brunt, I mean, we're hearing terms like unprecedented and catastrophic. Essentially, it's going to get worse, and Anna Bligh's not pulling any punches there. We will see wind speeds increasing. We will see storm surge and inundation of low-lying areas. We will see incredibly heavy rainfall and destruction of a lot of coastal infrastructure, erosion of the coastline as well going on. It is going to get worse, we know that, before it gets better, and that worse is going to go on for quite a long time.
Okay, well, James, you're a natural disasters expert, if you like. You've been to tsunami-ravaged areas, quake-ravaged regions and flooding areas. How has the lead-up to Cyclone Yasi been in comparison to the other natural disasters that you have been to?
Well, Cyclone Yasi is, we know it's been coming, which is useful because we can prepare for it. Some of the other types of natural disasters are a surprise. They come to us out of the blue and catch us off guard to a certain extent. This we've known has been coming, but equally because it's come after a large amount of flooding further south, there's really been a sense of great preparedness, I think. And Anna Bligh has done a sterling job in letting everyone know, letting the media know and letting the public know what's happening, not pulling the punches and saying this is going to be happening. So from a preparing for it point of view, this has been very, very well done, as much as possible.
That was going to be my next point. You can prepare as much as you like, but this is a life-threatening storm cell.
Oh, most definitely. And, you know, we haven't seen something like this, certainly in living memory, and it's very difficult to prepare for something you've never had before. So what will be happening is after this event, we will be preparing for that type of thing next time. We're just doing the best we can right now. And by judging by what's going on right now, we're doing a very good job at preparing for it.
How does this compare to other natural disasters in our recent history that you've focused on?
Well, I think you can look at things like Hurricane Katrina, for example, or you can look at the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami. Hurricane Katrina, there was a lot less preparedness there. You know, there were agencies were not interacting as well. Here we're seeing
they still knew that the flood was going to the river was going to breach the banks though in
that's
America,
right.
Didn't they?
They knew a lot was going to happen, but ultimately there was still a lot of chaos, disjointedness. And Here we're seeing state emergency services working remarkably well with all the different agencies involved and getting the message across to the public very quickly, letting them know what they should be doing. Ultimately, they're making a choice, but they're making an informed choice. That was not given to people in things like Hurricane Katrina and so on.
All right, we might have to leave it there. Professor James Goff, thank you very much for your time tonight.
Thank you.